everyone, and welcome to Spring Crafting Day 2. I am Nicole Westervelt back here in the video studio, and hopefully we're going to bring you some fun dose of creativity every day this week, and we'll see what happens in the coming weeks. But we are shaking it up here today a little bit because I'm not just with Roy. We are bringing in another guest just to kind of have some fun and some energy. Don't worry, we're socially distanced apart appropriately. But I am joined today by Roy, but also Kim Kesty. Yay!
Hello, everyone.
So for those of you that may have remember back in the old days when we used to do these events, we would have an MC sitting there and kind of monitoring comments and engaging. And so we thought, heck, let's bring someone in to do that. So Kim is filling that role today. So please engage with her, talk to her. We have Roy, of course, in his spot, as always. There we go, Roy. And so today is St. Patty's Day. And I know it's not really like a traditional St. Patty's Day, but I am wearing my green. I realized this morning that the project that we put together for you does not have green in it, but here's what I have for you to add a little green. My daughter Reagan wrote me a little note this morning. Reagan, of course, is home from school. She's hanging out with Dad and Grandpa. Grandpa's in town. So I have a little Happy St. Patrick's Day, I love you, and a little note from Reagan. So here's going to be our touch of green as we do our project today. So this project has a lot going on, I'm going to tell you. We've got a kinetic vibes in the card. We've got some of our new launches with our essential shapes. We're bringing in one of our fun new kaleidoscope products. So we've got a lot going on, and I'm going to jump in and get started. But again, remember, Kim is there to answer your questions, to engage. I'm sure we'll be bantering about a bit about things as we move through today. So first of all, I am going to start. This is going to be a window swing card. So a little fun, a little different. We like to try some different things around here. So what I am starting out with is just a traditional card base. So this is your traditional 8.5 by 11. So I'm going to go ahead and score that one down the center at 4.25, just like per usual. Let me pull this in. I've got a lot going on here on the set today. Okay, I'm not gonna fold it yet though, okay? And I'm gonna show you why in just a second. I just scored it there, I'm gonna set that aside. And then I have another piece here that is gonna serve as kind of our, what do you call it, Kim?
Your kinetic movement piece.
Yeah, it's like the movement piece. It's like the inners, it's the inner working piece.
The stuff that makes it happen.
The stuff that makes the magic happen. I'm putting my glasses on, y'all, because I can't see these numbers. Okay, so this I have cut. I kept it, it's again 5.5, so it's the same height as the card base, and I have it out at 3.25. I am going to trim that down, and I'll show you what I mean here in a bit. But what I'm going to do right now is score it at 2. And again at 4. So I'm going to get that scored. And then I'll set my scoring board aside. So how's everybody doing out there? Are we working from home? I will tell you that our team, the majority of our team is working from home at this point. So a lot of our project managers, our studio design teams, they are all working from home. We, of course, have a few of us here. Roy, though, I will tell you, comes in. He shoots the lives, and then he goes home to edit so that he can be home safe with his family as well. But we are making a bunch of changes here in the office, but we are continuing to ship, so that's something to keep in mind. All right, so I'm back to the project. So I have folded this guy like this. Okay, like Kim said, this is going to be the kind of kinetic-y piece, but I'm going to set it aside for just a second because now I'm going to address our card base. So notice there is the score line here, but I'm not going to fold it yet because I am going to bring in some glimmer. Now, I'm not going to glimmer here on set because I don't want to wait the time for it to heat up and such. It doesn't take that long, but while you're watching it on camera, it's pretty slow. So I'm bringing in some of our newest shapes. So you probably have seen these on a bunch of videos that we've done. These released recently, like about a month ago. And we have our essential squares with a piercing element every other. And then we have these cool glimmers that work perfectly with these shapes. Now you may have heard us tease that these shapes were really relaunched to be able to work with glimmer. And this is just the first of many glimmers that are coming that are going to be supporting these shapes. So stay tuned for that. But what I'm going to do right now is I am going to glimmer. So anytime that you're doing die cutting and or piercing and glimmer, you always want to foil first. And so I am going to pretend that I'm doing that. And so I'm going to take the largest frame here. And what I would do for this, if I were glimmering it live, is I would tape this down, create a hinge, and then slide my foil under it and glimmer it. let's pretend I did that. It doesn't make the sound of an embossing tool, but let's pretend it did. And then you get something like this. Okay, so again, the reason that I didn't actually fold it yet is so it could keep it nice and flush and flat on the Glimmer platform. But now that I have my thing, but I score it so that I have the line for reference. So that's why I score it ahead of time. So now we have this beautiful Glimmer frame, and now I'm gonna cut the window out of it. So I come back to my sets here, and now I'm gonna go into this.
Miss Nicole,
die.
Did you say what color foil you used?
Is it just your basic gold? I just use gold. I use gold.
Oh, perfect for St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah, I like the way we pretend we planned that when we really didn't, but it works for the story. So now I'm going to come in and cut the window out, okay? So this is going to be kind of the peekaboo piece. Now the reason that I want to show you this is, and you'll hear us say it all the time around here, foil first, but you have to be careful when you die cut because you do not want to have your washi tape touch the foil because it can remove the foil or dull the foil in the parts where the tape sits. So just kind of tape it down and then run that through. And then you get something like this. So now we have our card with our window and our foiled frame. So that is really the basis for this card. Now comes the fun part. That's adding the kinetic inners, as we said. So here's how we do that. I'm going to bring this back in. So again, this is the accordion fold. Now I put white liner on the back side here. You have to be careful when you're putting it in because white liner is not forgiving, but that's also why I like it, because it keeps the card really sturdy as people open and close it. So I'm going to start doing that. How are we doing over there, Kim? People hunkered down in their homes?
Yeah, we've got people watching, but not too many people commenting yet. I think they're too busy watching you.
Oh.
We always like comments, though, even after the live is over. So in other words, when it pops up as the recorded non-live version, if you're watching the replay, comment even if you're watching the replay.
Yeah.
We like that too.
Yeah, we had a woman yesterday ask, because you did a great video using a lot of our steel rule dies, and she asked if the steel rule dies were compatible with the Fisker's Fusion. I didn't know the answer to that, so we did some research and found some information on that, but our colleague Denzel, who knows machines inside and out, said yes, in fact, that they are compatible. So Maria, if you're watching, I answered the question online, but if you're watching here too, you can see that answer, so that's good to know. Okay, so now I have to make sure I don't do this wrong. Okay, so I'm going to put it like this. Yes, so I'm going to remove the strips here. And again, you got to be careful. You could use white glue. You could use tape runner. I use the white liner because it is so strong. But again, then you better get your placement right. And Kim watched me do this yesterday a few times, and I didn't get my placement right, but we're going to do it. Okay, so see how I have this kind of fold. I'm folding that under and I'm lining that up with the kind of top of this frame, or this kind of lip of this frame. Okay, see that? This is the hardest part of this whole card. And I close it, and then I flip this closed, and I push it down, and we hope like heck we've got it. Okay, so this is where that mechanism is going to come in here. Now you'll notice, you say, Nicole, you have a bunch of paper, you can't really see it in there, peeking out the end. Yes, I do. So what I'm going to do is just bring my trimmer in and do this. Now, like I said, I started with this sheet. See, that's kind of peeking out there. I started with this sheet at 5.5 by 6.75, knowing it was too long, but I'm not the best at the ruler, so I figured let's just make it too long, and then we can trim it off later. So I'm just going to bring our trimmer in and just shave off that little piece extra, and then we're good to go. So I don't know. I don't know. Is that an eighth? Is that a sixteenth? I don't know. Okay, so now we have the basis for our card. Now comes the fun part. We need to decorate it. So we're kind of obsessed around here with our kaleidoscope tile. So any of all of our kaleidoscopes, frankly. So we're going to be bringing that in. Actually, before I do that, though, I want to show you how we're going to kind of cover this. So when you die cut out this window, you were left with this square piece here, and that's the piece that we're going to use to kind of almost pop back in there. But I want to use one of these fun piercing dies, because why not? Now you could foil around this, but let's pierce. So I am going to bring in the next size down of piercing and run that through. But of course, if you're doing piercing, then you want something cute behind it to show through your poke holes. So, got a piece of buttercream here too, but let me run this through real quick. I'm gonna run it through a couple times, make sure we get all those pierce holes poked out. Pokey, pokey, pokies. All right, let's have a look-see here. Did we get it? Oh yeah. This is a great die. These things work really well.
I love the size of the pierce on that die.
It's pretty robust.
Like it's a pierce, but it's almost borderline tiny circle.
It really is.
You know, it's really
pretty.
Yeah,
it's a good size. So you see then when we back it, we can clearly see that detail.
So pretty.
So we cut out a piece of buttercream in the same shape and size as this guy. But just to prevent it from getting stuck, I'm going to trim a little bit of that off. Because you are trying to fit it through a window that's pretty much the same size. So, but I'm just going to shave a little. If I shave too much, then it won't show through the piercing holes. So just give a little trim, little trim. Speaking of trim, here's a funny one. We were just chatting before we went live about, Kim was saying that one of the, I guess, what is it, recommendations out there for people who have beards to prevent you from scratching your face is to shave your beard. Is that what you heard?
I heard, I don't know the actual reason, but my son has quite a large beard, and I immediately thought of him. I think it's because they think like the virus could be captured in there more than, ooh, I think touching your face. I think so. That's the gist I got from the article, but let's take a look at Roy.
I have no idea. I have no idea what you're talking about.
He claims that is not a beard, it's a goatee. I'm like,
oh, come on.
It's
a goatee out of control.
Very, how about mustaches? You got to shave mustaches too?
I think so. Why not?
I am dying to see what Roy looks like without facial hair, y'all. How about you guys?
Hey, chime and leave a comment if you wanted to do it. Yeah, do it.
So, Roy.
I have not been given permission.
I was going to say, does the wife have anything? Does the wife have anything to do with the beard? Does she like the facial hair?
She likes it, yes. And yeah. I don't. She's never seen me without it either.
Oh, I just touched my face. When you were I have seen a photo of you though when you were in film school at what is it, NYU?
Yeah, at NYU. Yeah.
He went to NYU film school, guys. That's the quality person we have sitting in our studio. Isn't that amazing? But you had really long hair. Did you have facial hair back then?
I did.
I'm trying to remember that photo.
I remember the hair.
I'm gonna have to dig that photo.
I shaved it off for a brief period.
Did you?
But it must have been back by then.
Yeah.
It was very long, though.
I'm
going
to have to take that picture back up. Yes, well, here's the deal. I think it would be quite an... I mean, we have to...
Okay, so Laura's just left a comment. Nicole can't see the comments, but she said, Corona challenge! Roy should shave his beard.
Oh, great.
And now I know we shouldn't be making light of this, y'all, but here's our thing.
Like, there are Corona challenges out there. I've seen that, like, in the crafting world even, too.
Okay.
You know, like, post something or share something you made, and they're kind of hashtagging Corona challenge. It can be a thing.
I mean, you have to have fun in life still, too. Be safe. Be smart, right? But
the only Corona challenge I'm interested in involves lime.
Oh.
And salt.
Touché. Gosh. Yeah. That's tough, tough biz for them. Okay. So I backed it in the buttercream. You see that here? Great, cool. And I had shaved just a little bit off, so you see that I had a little. Now I added my white liner just to one side because I'm going to mount it on this hingy part. And I'll show you what I mean. Actually, you could also put it right on the window, which probably would have been smarter, but hey. So I've got it as flat as I can get it. And I'm going to just line this up as close as I can to the window. Because if you don't, then it'll catch a little bit, and we don't want it to catch. Okay, so here we go. I'm gonna try to tighten up some of these creases a little bit here. Here we go. Okay, so you seeing how this is coming together? Whoa, see that, see that? So now though, while this is cute and all, I don't think I can send this card to anyone. I need to dress it up a bit. So now I wanna bring in the kaleidoscope tile. So hopefully you all are familiar with our Kaleidoscope collection. We actually have 4 SKUs now in the range, and they're meant to layer to create this really cool kaleidoscope effect. What I love about these dyes is that you can do a million and one things with them, because all you have to do is change your color palette, and then suddenly you have a completely different look. You layer them up with like multiples, and you can have a completely different look. Or you can even just use one or two of the pieces, and it's still stunning. So when we're doing this, we always say start with your color palette. Choose your color palette first. I will say Kim always helps me with this. I'm a little bit color challenged. I don't know how many of you might be as well. But Kim and Josie are always the ones that help me with the color palette, and then the rest is pretty easy. So we're going to go, this is the bottom one. And then we're going to put buttercream in the middle, and then we tend to really like this, the gold, the brushed gold on the kaleidoscope. It just works really, really well. And if you go watch any of our...
We like brushed gold on everything.
We really are a little obsessed. We are a little bit obsessed. We ran out like a couple weeks ago. All of a sudden we're like, why are we out of brushed gold? Like, we're using it on everything. But we're back in stock, so don't worry. Okay, so choosing the color palette here, and then when we cut them out, we're left with these pieces here. So, I mean... Well, this one's kind of lame, but these ones are quite pretty even on their own. I mean, look at that. But when they layer up, they're even more gorgeous. So let's do that now. I'm going to just bring in my white glue and layer them up. And again, what I like about the tile one, just one of these tiles is just really, it makes a great focal point. But I've seen a lot of cards where people do 4, like a quadrant of 4, and make a really cool square card. Just a lot of different options out there. We also have it in a triangle, and we have it in a petal, and we have it now in a strip too, which is kind of fun. So there's tons of videos out there about this collection, so go check that out. And you can see all the ways we've used them. Okay.
So Nicole,
yes,
speaking
ma'am?
Of favorite products,
ooh,
or even favorite techniques, I would love if people are watching again, whether they're watching live or on the replay, post if you would want to see us use a particular product, or
yeah,
share a particular technique, or maybe you have a product that's older, it's been hanging out, or maybe it's brand new in your collection.
Mm-hmm.
If you want us to use something this week, crafting, or even in the following weeks,
We're coming live every day this week, and we're like, well, what should we do now? What should we do now? So we're picking our favorites, but I'd like to know what yours are. That's a great point. Okay, so look at how gorgeous. Isn't that cool? And that's just going to drop in right there. So cool.
Fits perfectly. Love it.
Look at that. A square and a square and a square. I mean, really, this card has a little of everything. A little kinetic, glimmer, kaleidoscope. We also said this has a little bit of a masculine vibe. And I know everyone's always kind of looking for more masculine cards. I think it could go either way, but I think this definitely could be a great masculine card. All right, and then we need to add a sentiment. So you could add a sentiment right here across the tile, but we are going to add one down here on the bottom. And of course, for that, we'll bring in our glimmer. So we have tons of SKUs really now that have this very, this is what you call sans serif, right? Just sans serif font, tons and tons and tons of sentiments in our everyday sentiments too, and our more sentiment SKUs, and we have them for holiday. So I pulled this one, I think I pulled this one from our recent more sentiments, but there's tons of different options. So I just did For Someone Special, pretty generic. And then those glimmer sets also come with this guy so that you can easily cut that out. And so we would cut that out and add it to the bottom, and then bring in a little bit of our favorite, fashion gold. Now I will tell you, we are out of stock on these right now, but we are expediting production as soon as we can. Obviously, there's been a few delays in China with a lot of our production, but we're back up and running. The factories actually are running really well right now, and so we will be back in stock hopefully soon on that. But I know a lot of you have already stocked up on your fashion gold. So drop that in the middle. You could also kind of adorn all the corners and stuff, but just the singular middle piece is cute as well. And this is what the finished card looks like. Ta-da! Just classic, timeless, simple, and oh wait, there's this fun little surprise as it opens up. Pretty cool, right? Now you could also stamp a sentiment in here. We were looking at one of our Jane Whimsical and Wild stamps. This one I happen to love. I love the sentiment, what a difference one person can make. Pretty timely, I think, right now, that you could drop inside here, or just leave a blank and add your own sentiment. But there you go. So pretty fun, right? Ta-da. All right. Well, that kind of brings us to a close. Anything else, gang? Roy, how many votes do we have for Roy to shave his beard? I'll have to...
Zero.
Good. Well, thank you guys for tuning in and kind of, we're trying to have a little fun here today, but we do understand that a lot of you are going through a lot, super high anxiety. We're hoping that crafting and creating can be your creative outlet, bring you a little fun. And again, like Kim said, leave us some comments. What do you want to see us do this week? Are there any products or projects you want us to try, or do you want to challenge Kesty? I like that idea, to do something fun. So definitely leave your comments. We'll go back and answer questions as they pop up. And until then, enjoy bringing paper to life.